Okay, so this is the incenter, X1, the first on Clark Kimberling's Encyclopedia of Triangle Centers. This worksheet here, it's a Geometer's SKetchpad worksheet, is actually taken from Clark Kimberling's website. It shows us a triangle ABC and two of the three angle bisectors. There's one and there's another, and the place where they meet right here is the incenter X1. And because this is a dynamic geometry package, we can move these points around and we can see that, well, the properties are maintained. In particular, the incenter is the center of a circle which touches all three sides of the triangle. The third angle bisector from here to here is not shown, but we could show that if we went over here and we took the ray. And we connected this point to this point. Well, there we go. Then we would get the third angle bisector. And probably we should change its properties a little bit, make it red, and probably make it thin. And now it looks more like the other three. All right, so in fact, it's worth pointing out that there's three other points that are important here. If we take an angle bisector and look at a line perpendicular to it, so we construct, let me take that line and that point and construct a perpendicular line. There we go. And we do the same thing for this angle bisector and that point, construct a perpendicular line. Then we see that we get a point over here, which is in some sense playing a similar kind of role. It's called an excenter. And there's in fact three of them. There's one over here as well, and there's also one down there below the page that you can't see. All right, so these four points are, in my view, to be thought of rather symmetrically. They're all incenters as far as I like to think about them. And this is really a very lovely, important point, and there's all kinds of rich symmetry involved with the incenter and its four quadrilateral of incenters really associated to a triangle. So X1 from Clark Kimberling's list.